You got it? I got it.
So if you didn't hear any of that, not on mic, my name is Marie. No, it's Cole. And it occurred to me. I should follow? Yes. Can I sit?
Yes.
Yes? I'm allowed to sit?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
What's her name?
Meredith, you don't
right?
have a table?
Yeah.
No, I'm just kidding. Please. Jeez, can we get this over with? Thank you for trying your best, Meredith. Okay, I'm going to hold my phone for a minute so I don't overtalk this, because I didn't know that I could have put up cue cards right there. That would have been really cool. I'm Cole, again, Anne-Marie, Anne Rivera. It occurred to me this morning that it might have been prudent to perhaps review other people's trying their best and figure out how they started these, because I don't know. But I will say that recently I had a milestone, and that was that I was in jail for 2 nights, which some of you know about. And it had me thinking about community, which is weird, but something I've been thinking about since I was 12. I'm going to stand up. Good point. Anyway, Jeff, are you giving time or no? I don't know. It's something I've been thinking about for a really long time, because I had one of those typically atypical upbringings where my mom and my dad married each other, then married each other, then married other people and tried that too. And sorry? That would have been good too. Anyway, the point being, parents, the usual mess up, and me, an only child, except I had a half sibling that my dad adopted when I was 12, so that's a real salt in the wound, right? And I was always kind of a weirdo. I was a smart kid, which sounds like a humble brag, or just a brag, except I bet a lot of people in this room have been the smart person, and you know how isolating that actually is. I started reading before I was 3, and I remember in 7th grade, Mrs. Elam just kind of handing me St. Edna St. Vincent Millay and just kind of like backing up. So kids, kind of, that was challenging, but parents and adults were worse. Thanks, Mary. Parents are different. People are adults are deferential to smart kids, and they make you let you make too many decisions. So, like when I was in 3rd grade, they suggested that I go into junior high, and that decision was left to me. And so my point being that as a kid, all growing up, my parents sucked, and I was an only child, and I made all the decisions. I started balancing the checkbook when I was 10. I was just always in charge, and I was always the smart one. So I didn't have a lot of experience with letting other people help or other people even trying to help. And there were glimmers of joy in that, but... Someone just help me with this microphone. But anyway, I don't know what my time is because of all of this stuff. Anyway, this last year sort of changed things. In the last year, I had all of the stressors that might show up on a checklist for life stressor events, like I was getting divorced from my really terrible ex-husband in the worst divorce ever. My dogs were taken away. I was being sued. That didn't even make top billing. My grandmother was dying. My mother was dying. I had to have surgery. Finances were bad. I was falling apart all at once. And all of a sudden, I needed people. And that's not really a thing I'm accustomed to or good at. And some people definitely stepped away. People I've known for 10 years and went on vacation with. And then some people unexpectedly really stepped up. Jeff went and picked up my prescriptions from CVS on a Friday from Santa Monica during rush hour traffic.
Oh my God. That's friendship.
I don't know anyone I would do that for. But, so I am a weirdo, and I need a lot of alone time, and I write, and I use weird words, and I'm hard to relate to, and I get all that, and I'm late, like I'm terrible in a lot of ways. But I'm loving, and I needed help, and people stepped up. And then recently, I was in jail, bringing it back to that, which, if you hadn't heard, I've been getting a divorce, and my ex-husband attacked me. I called the police, and they took me to jail. And so that was fun. But my thought at the time was, this is fine. They're going to let me out. That's fine. I'm very angry, but they're going to let me out. I should really let Fernanda know that I can't make the concert tomorrow night. And I had actually texted Jeff and another friend to say, hey, I'm pretty upset. Can I come by? I should let them know I'm okay. And my mom was having surgery, and I wanted to let her know I wouldn't be able to talk to her. I would be unreachable. Pretty calm about it. I'm good in an emergency. I don't get emotional, and I can handle other people's problems. So that was my basic take on it. Unbeknownst to me, all of you were at work, or many of you are at work, which is something for me to think about and contend with, I guess. I don't know how to signal to people that I need help. I don't know how they know I need help. I don't know that whole thing, that whole being with people thing, I think is just the biggest struggle in life. And as I got out of jail on, was it Wednesday afternoon? I came out and I saw somebody who looked like Ryan sitting on a park bench, and I thought, that guy looks like Ryan, and also, why is he waiting for a bus? And turns out that Fernanda talked to Jeff, and Jeff talked to so many other people, and they had made some sort of, I guess, task force to check on my car and raise bail money. And that was, so when I saw Jeff, I'm sorry, when I saw Ryan when I got out of jail, I was really astonished, and he made the point that I was in really good spirits, which I was, because I didn't know anyone was going to get me out. I was so touched. And a couple days later, I felt sad, and I had to contemplate it all. But in that moment, you're right, I was really well-adjusted. I don't think this has an ending, except that I feel like I've been meditating on the nature of being myself and being with other people since I was 12 and reading psychoanalytic theory. And it continues. And I want to be a help to you, and I am going to try to figure out how to tell people when I need things. And that's me trying my best.
Yes. So. Awesome. We'll take it.